Hi guys! Welcome back to my channel. So today is Valentine's Day and I have a special video for you guys. So today I'll be doing an open letter video, and what it is that an open letter can be any letter, and I will be so-called answering a letter which is dedicated to me by my ex on the things that he never really get an answer before. So this is me replying it to him. I'm not gonna mention names, I'm not gonna say who it is, which one of my ex-boyfriend it is, but I'm just gonna put it out there and answer this, okay? There are 19 paragraphs in all, and let's start. Can I ask you something? Did you ever regret choosing me? Did you ever regret loving me? Did you ever regret giving me your heart? Did I ever make you feel like I didn't love you? I didn't care for you? Did you feel glad that I was gone? Did you feel happy when I started to stray away from you? Okay, that is a lot of question in one paragraph, but I'm gonna answer, at least try to answer every one of it. I did not regret choosing you because I chose to be in love with that person. So no, I do not regret choosing you, nor do I regret loving you, nor do I regret giving you my heart. To be honest, if I'm in a relationship, I want it to go somewhere, which in this case, obviously marriage. In that 4 years of me together with you, I feel like I'm the one who giving in to the relationship more than you do. Like, I can commit to the relationship like really, really freaking seriously because I wanted the relationship to eventually ended up in a marriage. You seem to not think of what is ahead, like what is the future gonna be like with me in it, like how I vision it with you, or whether you see me as someone in your life. Like, I'm not sure if you have that thinking, but to me, when I look at you, you just think of what is gonna happen tomorrow or what is gonna happen later, but nowhere near what is gonna happen way ahead. That's the problem with you. And despite me saying it over and over again, I don't know, you just seems to like not really serious, or if you are serious, it's like you are not showing it that you are really, really serious. So you know what I'm trying to say? In the relationship, I have been giving and you have been receiving, so eventually I'm tired of the relationship, and when that happens, my feelings for you slowly fades. It fades and then it goes off to nothing. I had to leave when I had to leave. Leaving you was the toughest because the love has changed into pity, and I did want to stay because I was pitiful of you, but then at the same time, if I'm pitiful of you, who is gonna pity me, right? So the next paragraph is, were you ever waiting for my texts or calls when you decide to be alone? Did you ever think about texting or calling me just to check on me or how I was doing? Did you talk to anyone about me? Did you ever think that I was a waste of time? Was I ever a waste of your effort, of your love, of patience? When I decide to leave, no, I did not. I did not expect or I did not wait for your call or texts because I had enough. Like I said, my love for you has faded into nothing, so there is no more room for my love towards you. It is to a point that my patience for you stretched enough that it snaps and I just have to leave, like I said. I did talk about you to my friends in helping me to decide whether I should be staying or should I be leaving, because clearly there is no spark or there is no sense of love, so I decided to go. Now that I think of it, like when I look back, are you a waste of my time? I can say yes, because I was in a relationship with you from 19 up till I'm 23. So that is like 4 years of my life wasted, despite me giving full commitment, wanting to be your, you know, wedded wife. But I don't see my future with you in it. I just decide to go, you know? I mean, at the end of the day, you are the one who is going to say the vows and not me. You are the one who is gonna ask my hand in marriage and not the other way around. And you are the one going to be the head of the family. So basically, I left also because of your financial problems. Like, I can save up, but you can never save up, which I do not understand why. Like, I don't know where your money goes, seriously. I pay for everything, like when we, almost all the time that I pay for our outing. So I do not understand. You notice how these are all questions? Because I never got any answers. I'm probably never going to send you this. I know I should, but I know that I can't. I promise you a lot of things. I promise you that I won't hurt you intentionally. I promise you that I wouldn't do this and I wouldn't do that. I promise you that I'll fight for you. Maybe I wanted you to fight a little harder for us too. But that was already too much to ask, wasn't it? Maybe I wanted you to hold on to my hand and give me a minute to settle the war that was raging inside my head. To settle the chaos that was happening so abruptly. Yeah, you had so much question because I left you just like that. Like, I left because there is no need for explanation, I feel. Because despite countless of time that I told you that the relationship is seriously not going anywhere, but you are like, today I tell you and you take it seriously, and the next you just forget about it. Like, yeah, you promised all those to me, but those are just words. They are all empty promises that I don't see you doing it. So I had enough after 4 years. You wish for me to fight for you a little harder? Like, hello, I've been fighting for this relationship to work out. Like, after the second year when you ask me to be your fiancé, I've been really, really committed, like savings and stuff like that, but you are nowhere near even committed. Rather, you're just like in your old world, in your own routine that you never want to change. So don't say that you wanted me to fight for the relationship a little bit harder, because I've been the one who is fighting for it, unlike you. I'm sorry if you lost me, but sometimes when precious things are right in front of you, you don't know how to, you know, cherish it, treasure it with tender love and care, and then it just disappears, and then that's when you realize and you regret. But it's a little bit too late for that, you know. You left me to be alone with your thoughts that never seemed to leave your head, nor were they translated into words. To think things through, to settle the war between your own mind and heart, and to decide whether what we had and I were still worth fighting for. I left you alone there and then, without any words for me to even say, because like I say, I was feeling very pitiful over you that I had to leave you. Like, I'm easily pitiful over people, so I might not have the heart to leave you if I were to tell you that I'm leaving you and yada yada yada. So I just left like that. I know it's mean, but I guess at that point of time, you needed it to realize what you once had has just flown by because of your lack of seriousness and lack of commitment in a relationship, basically. As I was left in the ruins of us, I tried to pick up the pieces left in the rubble. I dug through the ashes of what used to be good and figured things out on my own. I was so sure that I'll keep fighting for you. I was so sure that I was ready to give all the fight that was left in me, because that's how much I loved you. I do not understand what that paragraph means. But if I left you like that and got you thinking and looking back at our relationship, like where is it gone wrong or something, and then you finally realize, or I'm not sure if you even realize it, like where is the wrong in it? Know this, even after I left, I was still looking from afar, just seeing if you are okay, just looking if you found someone who replaced me. So when you finally did, I'm really happy for you, because it's time to move on. And I just hope that you don't treat whoever you're with currently like how you treat me. Like, don't take people's heart for granted. Okay, then there were times that I wasn't so sure anymore. At this moment, as I'm writing this now, I don't exactly know what it is that I'm feeling. Was I honestly that terrible of a person? Was I not worth the love and the effort anymore? Has your patience really stretched as far as it could? Has your heart hardened that way because of my doing? Yes, because you didn't want to change when I let you know what I'm feeling, like what I am seeing wrong in the relationship. You just, okay, I will change. Okay, I will change. And then you did nothing. You don't take it seriously, like what I'm saying. Like, you think that I always want to win in a argument, but what I'm saying is, you know, if you're in a relationship and something don't work out, you have to work it out and talk and voice out and do something about it. Not like just go in and the information gets out. Then it defeats the purpose in, you know, fixing a relationship. And if it has been ongoing for 4 freaking years, you think I can spend a lifetime to be with you? No, I don't think so. So yes, throughout that years, my patience has been stretched until I had enough and it snapped and adios, you know? Maybe it really was my fault. Maybe it was my madness that caused you to reach your end. I guess that's just how a broken heart and a directionless mind make you think and feel. It makes you cringe at yourself because of your mistakes and because you thought you ruined something good, something beautiful, and something irreplaceable. So like I mentioned, the precious thing that you have in front of you, you tend to forget or you tend to care less because you know that something who has been around through thick and thin and you think that person will never leave you. But know this, each one of us has a limit to everything. When we can no longer take it, we will just go. It is too late to regret. Like, it's really too late for that. I'm not entirely sure if I'm going to thank you for the broken heart, but thank you for the lesson nonetheless. Thank you for reminding me of how strong I am. I was able to get up in the morning and go about the day as if everything were normal. As if I was having a normal day, just without you in it. It seems like the hardest thing to do at first, but I did it anyway. I did it for me. Like, I'm proud of you that you finally moved on and found someone. You have been doing good without me. And I'm actually proud, or somehow I was trying to change you to be a better man. I'm not sure what else changed, but I guess I taught you the value of saving up, the very least. So, you know, so whoever you are with now, I'm sure you already know how to save up and spend your money wisely. Thank you for being there for me and my family during the toughest time. Thank you for being there for me when I couldn't find a job or a decent client. Thank you for believing in me when almost nobody else did, myself included. Thank you for loving me when I was the least lovable person in the world. Thank you for taking care of me the way that you have. After all this time, even if it means taking off me first before you get to take care of yourself, and after you knew that it was breaking your heart too. And I realized, I guess when you wrote that paragraph, you know I have been a good girlfriend to you. I have been committed to you. So with you saying all that, you know that I really value you, value the relationship, value us. But again, you weren't serious enough, committed enough to be in a relationship or to be in a next phase of the relationship, like to be in a marriage wise. Because seriously, you know, I guess I deserve the heartbreak. I had it coming because I broke your heart while you were still with me and I couldn't see that you weren't happy anymore. I understand why you needed to break my heart, and maybe because it was just fair, because it was the right thing to do. And I'm glad you saw my actual purpose of me leaving you was the reason I did it. And I'm glad you realized that without me having to tell you. So you already know the answer. I hugged you the tightest when you felt like you weren't good enough, when you were so lost because your future looked so blurry and you couldn't see a clear path towards your finish line. I assured you that I'll help you follow your dreams because I said I'll follow them with you. I assured you that on the day that you get to finally reach your finish line, I will be the one standing there, waiting for you with open arms, ready to hug you and congratulate you for a job well done. I gave you hugs that felt like armor, because I know that no matter how strong you make everyone else think you are, inside you is still a child that needs comfort, protection, rest, and a child that needs love. Basically, like I said, I've been giving in the relationship, giving too much, and you've been taking too much. And you know that I wanted something like for you to give it back to me, to feel like, you know, there is a connection of a give and take kind of situation. Because when in a relationship, the give and take situation lacks, it's not gonna work. It's not gonna work. I know as I'm talking, you guys won't understand or probably don't even get it because it's not your relationship. This video is entitled to him but publicly made for you guys to watch. So don't judge, just watch with open mind, okay? Because obviously you guys won't agree with what I'm saying or have no idea what I'm talking about. I saw the best in you when you thought that no one else could. Or at least that time when you called me and you were in tears because of something that your dad says that really hurts you. I cried with you too. I felt everything so deeply just like you did. When you got hurt, I did too. I reminded you that no matter what happens, I will always be proud of you and your magic, and that you were so much more than what other people think you are. I guess this part is somehow true because you are good at listening. Like my problems, like my sorrows, you are good at lending, you know, a shoulder to cry on, basically. I love you with all that I could and with all that I had. I took care of you and made sure everything was convenient for you. I'm sorry if that was never enough or it was always too much. I'm not telling you everything that I did to get you reconsider. I put it out here to serve as a reminder that I was good to you too. Yes, you are good to me. Your attitude has no problem with me. It's just that your habits is a problem to me, okay? If a habit that you can't change, it's difficult. Yeah, your love is great, I guess. But love is not enough. Love doesn't buy money, and money doesn't buy love, okay? Love, technically, like really, really, okay? Like the feeling of being in love, you can't get it with money. And money can't buy love, like really love, okay? So if let's say I were to be married to you, I will be the sole breadwinner because it has been that way throughout the relationship. I've been supporting you the most, which I do not understand, and I feel like I am the guy in the relationship which really beats the purpose because, like you say, I am a child that wants to be pampered as well, you know, with tender love and care. But it is always the other way around. I send you to work, I do all the guy things, and then when it's my turn for you to send me to work, it's like you can't do it because I stay too far. But I can come to you regardless of me staying far, you know? I stay in a west area and you are in the center of Singapore, but I can come over to you and send you to work. But when it's your off day, you can't do that to me. And when it's your off day, you can't even fetch me, you know, without us getting into a quarrel because you are tired. So me coming to you, am I not tired? I work shifts too, like same like you, so I don't get it why I can have the time to spare for you but you can't. I understood all the times that you push me away, even if it was hard for me to accept. I respected your decision because I know I'm in no place to compete with your mind and your heart. I let you heal on your own. I've always thought that the intensity of our love for each other were far greater than any of our problems and any of the trials and the difficulties along the way. I went through thick and thin with you, like any problems at all. But I can't get through the habit of yours not giving a commitment in the relationship, in money-wise especially, okay? Like, I'm a girl, okay? Half of the girl out there, if let's say they want to get married, they don't want to be feeling like I'm the only one who is saving up. And then the guy always comes to you like, hey, I don't have any transport money, can I use from the fund? Or hey, I don't have any cigarette money, can I use from the fund? Like, can I come to you and say, hey, I need money to, you know, spend on my makeup and stuff? Or hey, I need money to go and spend on my clothes and stuff. I can stop those just to be committed and save up. But you're essential, you can't handle it on your own. So how is it when, if let's say we are married and we have a house, we have a kid, who are going to handle those if your own personal needs, you can't handle it? You get what I'm trying to say? I've always thought that you were a fight that I would die for. You and what we had were worth fighting for, and so I did. I fought with all my strength and my might. No matter how tired I felt, how badly I wanted the needed to rest, I always got up and fought again. I didn't complain to anybody, I didn't ask questions, because I understood that this is what it meant to be in love. This is what I needed to do to fight for what I really wanted. If this phrase right here, you have been doing it in the beginning of our relationship throughout the 4 years, I guess there shouldn't be any problems. But after I left, it's only when you start fighting, it is too late to realize that you lost the love of your life. It is seriously too late. Because once you lost love, no matter what you do, it is highly, like the chances are so slim, like I can fall in love with you again, you know? One day along the way of the journey to get back to you, I realized that I might have already been defeated, that there was nothing left for me to fight for anymore, that the war was over and that I have lost. Indeed, because you realize a bit too late when I actually left you. This would be the part where I will fully accept my defeat. Goodbye to you, to our memories, to our deepest, darkest secret, to our habits and our usuals. I'm gonna miss it, and with all of me. I guess this is how our story ends. I'll find a way to forget about all the things that you left for me to remember, and I'll try my hardest to make new memories of my own. Good luck to you, and I'm glad that you found someone to replace me finally after 3 years. I can't imagine the day that I will be completely okay again, but I'm wishing for it for myself. Someday, I'll forgive you for breaking my heart, and I hope you forgive me for breaking yours. On that same day, I hope I forgive myself too. I forgive you, and I'm glad that you forgive yourself and you are able to love again. That's why you got married. I hope it is like that, and not because you're trying to forget me, or because, I don't know, whatever your reason is, I hope you married someone because you really love that someone. And please do not take that someone feeling for granted like how you did to me, okay? So thank you for everything that we've been through. I wouldn't be the me that I am now if it weren't for you. Wherever life takes you, I hope it always makes sure that your heart is happy. Thank you for everything, my love. And for the last time, I'm sorry and I love you. I hope likewise for you. Seriously, just know this. If you're watching, do not take people kindness for granted. Do not take people's love for granted, because you won't realize how precious they are until they are gone, and then it's a little bit too late for you to regret it later on. Okay, so that is it, guys. This is my open letter video to my ex-boyfriend. I hope you guys find it interesting, and I don't know, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't to see more videos from me, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Okay guys, bye.